Welcome to this video review of our seventh concert in the Brighton Philharmonic Orchestra's 2017-18 concert season. I am Ian Brignall and I am the concert manager for the orchestra. In this concert, we welcome back Stephen Bell and introduce the trumpeter Gareth Small. The programme visits the music of Russia with an overture by Glinka, a musical visualisation of A Night on a Mountain by Mussorgsky, a brilliant and soloist challenging trumpet concerto written by the Armenian composer Alexander Aratunian, and possibly one of the greatest of Russian symphonies, Tchaikovsky's magnificent Fourth Symphony. Mikhail Glinka was born in 1804 into a wealthy family and worked as a civil servant before studying music in Italy and Berlin. In 1834, he returned to Russia, and after studying ancient volumes and music of his native country, led him to compose a national opera based on the ancient story of Ivan Zuzanin. The opera was renamed as A Life for the Tsar, as a thank you after Tsar Nicholas I attended a rehearsal before its first performance in 1836. The opera tells the story of a young Russian peasant who, at the expense of his own life, saves the Tsar from a group of Polish kidnappers. It was given its first performance on the 27th of November 1836 in St. Petersburg, and it was a great success and became one of the first truly Russian operas, Glinka, in fact, becoming the father of modern Russian music. And certainly Richard Wagner used some of Glinka's compositional techniques in his operas. Glinka's romantic and nationalistic writing was certainly a huge influence on the Russian composers that succeeded him. This overture has certainly become a popular item in concert programmes. Modest Mussorgsky was born in 1839 and started writing A Night on a Bare Mountain as a musical picture based on legends and stories of a witch's Sabbath on St. John's Eve, which is on June the 23rd. He in fact completed it on that day in 1867. It has latterly been recognised as one of the first tone poems written by a Russian composer. The piece, though, was never performed in Mussorgsky's lifetime, as his mentor, Mili Balakirev, was very critical of the piece and refused to have it performed. Mussorgsky tried to salvage parts of it and tried unsuccessfully to include it in various other works. It wasn't until 5 years after Mussorgsky's death in 1886 that Rimsky-Korsakov edited the work and had the work performed. This is the version that we will hear today. After its very successful first performance in 1868, it has become a concert favourite ever since. It gained even more fame in 1940 when it was included in Walt Disney's film Fantasia. The work is originally named as St. John's Eve on a Bald Mountain and is split into four distinct dramatic sections: Assembly of the Witches and Their Chatter and Gossip, Satan's Cortege, Black Mass, and Sabbath. Alexandra Aratunian was born in Yerevan, Armenia in 1920. He was clearly a very talented child, joining the Yerevan Conservatoire Children's Group at age 7. At 14, he joined the Conservatoire, studying piano and composition, graduating from there in 1939. He continued his studies in Moscow in 1946, but returned to Yerevan, where he took up a position at the conservatory and in 1954 was appointed artistic director of the Armenian State Philharmonie. The trumpet concerto was completed in 1950 and was premiered in the Tchaikovsky Hall in Moscow the same year. The concerto is in five distinct sections and is a showpiece for trumpet, demanding a huge technique. But it has movements and moments of lyrical writing, and its melodic and rhythmic strength come from the folk minstrel improvisations of Armenian folk music, which are a strong influence in many of Aratunian's composition. Today's soloist is the principal trumpet from the Halle Orchestra, Gareth Small. Our final piece in this programme is probably one of the most popular of all symphonies, Tchaikovsky's Symphony No. 4. Written between 1877 and 1878, its first performance was in Moscow on February the 22nd, 1878, with Nikolai Rubinstein as the conductor. It is and was an instant success and confirmed Tchaikovsky as one of music's leading symphonic composers. This is a towering symphony with great writing for an orchestra, from its tense and gripping opening motifs to its completely joyous ending. Tchaikovsky had just met his new patroness, Nadezhda von Neck. His disastrous marriage had been a tough time for him, and he wanted very much to dedicate this new symphony to his new friend, and that he would write on it, "Dedicated to my best friend." The symphony is in four movements and follows carefully the structure of the symphony. The third movement is interesting in that the strings play pizzicato, or by plucking the strings throughout, which is unusual writing, but creates a fabulous effect. The final movement is Tchaikovsky at his happiest, and the second theme is based on a very famous Russian folk song, "In the field stood a birch tree." The symphony then accelerates to its conclusion with vigorous and triumphant writing for the orchestra. I look forward to seeing you at this concert with music from three great Russian masters and an Armenian composer who really knows how to write for a trumpet and an orchestra.